Now, today we are going to talk about virtual courts, Parliamentary Standing Committee on Personal Public Grievance, Law and Justice has recommended holding virtual courts even after the pandemic ends. Now, what is the importance of virtual courts and how this has become one of the major and important ways to give justice to the people of this country? Now, virtual courts ensure digital justice, which is cheaper and faster, and also addresses local and economic handicaps. It will ensure safety of vulnerable witnesses who provide testimony and expedite the process and procedure that are an improvement of traditional courts. There are about 3.1 crore cases pending in the lower courts, 44 lakh in the High Court, and 60,000 cases in Supreme Court. Prisons in India have over the capacity of 114%, of which two-thirds are under trials who have had no justice at all. Virtual courts reduce pendency cases by reducing the time taken on small financial issues, insurance claims, traffic challans. Certain cases such as tax matters, insurance, corporate matters could move to an online dispute resolution such as arbitration and conciliation. So it's a great way to move forward, great way to resolve the pending cases, great way to provide security and safety to the people who are delivering with justice, which includes both the criminals as well as the judiciary. So what are some of the challenges? Well, the challenges could be on technical level, when there could be audio or video failures and lack of connectivity, especially in the rural areas. Unless connectivity established, compelling the use of virtual court should not be mandated. So before we delve into the era where virtual justice is given in terms of proceedings and hearings, it is important to ensure that proper connectivity is there. Encouraging new protocols without understanding uses and applications will disempower the poor even further. So we need to understand the implications of providing virtual courts. Lawyers need to interrupt when they feel argument of their counterparts are factually inaccurate. This is not possible in case of virtual courts, as the host mutes the participants. So this is something which can be resolved through a virtual session in which everyone gets the opportunity to speak at the same time. Facial expressions such as fear, guilt, regret, anger, which can affect the case, is almost negligible in case of virtual courts. Well, the solution could be for this that cases belonging to severe or heinous crimes, they could be left away from the ambit of virtual courts, because there is a lot of things to be deciphered, especially from the facial expressions. Therefore, the crucial matters that needs direct human interaction should never be replaced by human courts. So only the cases which can and involves not involvement of human interaction more and could be solved without being present there should definitely be referred to virtual courts.